At a time where any given day could literally be your last, gearing up for the season comes with a whole different set of challenges.
It was difficult, you know, coming in and having that momentum in camp, then backing off thinking that we're not going to have a season, didn't have to flip the switch again and come back. But, I mean, it was hard, it was difficult, but as a team, we stuck together, and, I mean, we out here doing it, so.
It was kind of like a upside-down moment because everybody was so unsure, and then kind of when we found out we was playing, it got a boost, everybody was on track with it. Everybody came together, so, okay, we're going to play, let's ball out then.
Especially in an environment like this where you're going to class each day with, you know, all these uncertainties, when you come and be with the guys that you've been, you know, working with all summer, it kind of just takes that weight off your back.
Believe it or not, the regular season starts on September 19th. So right now, less than 20 FCS programs are competing this fall, adding a unique perspective to this finite season.
This year in particular shows who really won it, because, I mean, you had time to sit at home and not do nothing, and it really goes down to if you really want to prepare while you're at home or you want to sit around and not do nothing. So when we get out there on the field and who's dominating, you can see who really took that.
We were all just excited to be back, excited to be playing football, meeting again, just being together as a unit, being able to enjoy each other's company and fellowship.
We're a family, so when we had that time apart, you know, you could very much feel the energy when we got back. Guys were laughing, the joy in the room, in the meeting rooms, all that, you know, stuff that guys kind of take for granted, you know, they loved it.
It's a blessing to be able to come out here and perform, especially during a global pandemic, but this is the fact that we get the opportunity to play, and a lot of people don't. We just have to take advantage of that opportunity.
All things considered, the extra weeks of prep will certainly be appreciated. The Camels sprint out of the gates, facing three teams out of the Sun Belt.
I mean, it's an opportunity for us to go out there and show that we can play with anybody else. And as a team, it can show that just we're bigger than the Big South. I mean, that's the conference we in, but we can compete against anybody in the country.
We're not looking at it like it's a, you know, David or Goliath type game. We're just looking at it as another football game against 11 dudes that strap up and play just like us. So we're ready to go to war.